Professor Pratibha, I welcome you back in our...
Yes, we are teachers, lifelong learners. I, Professor Pratibha, I welcome you back in our YouTube channel. आज मैं आपसे कुछ बात करना चाहूंगी क्योंकि आज तक के जितने भी वीडियोस मैंने अपलोड किए हैं, ऑलमोस्ट मोर देन 90% वीडियोस, दे आर नथिंग बट माय वर्चुअल टीचिंग और द क्लासरूम टीचिंग वीडियोस. सो यहाँ पे आज मैंने ये सोचा नहीं था कि मैं कुछ ऐसे वीडियो जिसमें मेरे स्टूडेंट्स नहीं है, मैं कुछ ऐसे वीडियोस भी यूट्यूब पे अपलोड करूंगी. लेकिन जो मुझे कमेंट्स आए थे, क्योंकि अभी का जो सिचुएशन है बहुत ही सेंसिटिव सिचुएशन है, जिसमें बच्चे ऑनलाइन क्लासेस अटेंड कर रहे हैं, उनके पास लर्निंग मटेरियल नहीं है, तो मुझे ऐसे लग रहा है कि ये हमारी एक जिम्मेदारी है, ये हमारी एक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि जो स्टूडेंट टीचर्स है उनकी हम हेल्प करें. उनका जो भी एमसीक्यू का प्रैक्टिस है वो होना बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है. सबसे पहले जिस कॉलेज में मैं पढ़ाती हूँ वो स्टूडेंट टीचर्स को मैं बहुत थैंक यू बोलना चाहूँगी. और क्योंकि जिनकी वजह से कि मुझे ऐसे लगता था कि जो भी एब्सेंट रहते हैं ताकि उनका नुकसान ना हो और वो ये वीडियोस बाद में भी देख सके, ये मोटो लेके मैंने कुछ वीडियो यूट्यूब पे अपलोड किए थे. लेकिन अभी ये टाइम है तो सभी के लिए, मतलब ना ही मेरे कॉलेज के स्टूडेंट टीचर्स के लिए, बट सभी के लिए मैं ये वीडियो बना दूँ. ने अलग अलग यूनिवर्सिटीज़ ने डिक्लेयर किया है आपके एग्ज़ाम सभी नेक्स्ट मंथ में होने वाले हैं. आपके एग्ज़ाम फॉर्म अभी मुझे लगता है कि 15 तक का डेट दिया हुआ है, और आपका जो भी एग्ज़ाम फॉर्म है वो भी आपका 15 जून तक आपका फिलअप हो जाएगा. तो अभी थोड़ा सा टेंशन में आपको लग रहा है कि अभी, या तो ये एक चीज़ ऐसे है, ये तो एग्ज़ाम आपको वर्चुअली देनी है, आपको ऑनलाइन एग्ज़ाम देनी है, और दूसरी बात ये है कि अभी तक आपको जिसकी आदत थी, जो भी थ्योरी पेपर्स आप देते थे, अभी आपको एमसीक्यू टाइप आपको एग्ज़ाम देनी है. तो एक तो लर्निंग मटेरियल अवेलेबल नहीं है, ऊपर से ये एमसीक्यू एग्ज़ाम देना है. बट दोनों में फ़र्क क्या है, क्योंकि जब भी आप कोई भी थेरोटिकल आप एग्ज़ाम देते हो उसमें आप अगर कुछ लिखते हो, रिलेवेंट चीज़ें कुछ अगर लिखते हो, तो आपको थोड़े बहुत मार्क्स मिलने के चांसेस होते हैं जो एमसीक्यूज में नहीं होते. या तो आपको फुल मार्क्स मिलते हैं या तो आपके पूरे मार्क्स चले जाते हैं. तो ये वहाँ पे भी एक तरीका है कि आप एमसीक्यू कैसे सॉल्व करते हैं. तो इसके लिए शुरुआत कहाँ से होती है, ठीक है, हम आपको एमसीक्यू का कुछ प्रैक्टिस दे रहे हैं, लेकिन एक्चुअली शुरुआत कैसे है, जब भी आप कोई भी लर्निंग मटेरियल पढ़ते हो, वो लर्निंग मटेरियल पढ़ने के टाइम पे तभी आपके दिमाग में आना चाहिए कि इसके ऊपर एमसीक्यू कैसे पूछ सकते हैं. तो अगर आपको इसमें इंटरेस्ट है, अगर आप इसके बारे में जानना चाहते हैं, तो कोई भी एक एक स्कूल मैनेजमेंट का टॉपिक लेके मैं आपको ये ज़रूर बताना चाहूँगी कि पढ़ने के टाइम पे आप एमसीक्यू आपके दिमाग पे कैसे फ्रेम कर सकते हो, आप कैसे पता लगा सकते हो कि इसके ऊपर ऐसे एमसीक्यू पूछा जा सकता है, ताकि आपकी अच्छे तरीके से तैयारी हो और आप एग्ज़ाम बहुत अच्छी तरीके से दे सके. सच में आपको इसके ऊपर कोई वीडियो चाहिए तो प्लीज़ आप आपके कमेंट्स कमेंट बॉक्स में लिख लीजिए, ताकि आपके लिए मैं इसके ऊपर वीडियो बना सकूं. और आप अभी थोड़ा सा डरे हुए मुझे लग रहे हो, थोड़े परेशान हो, लेकिन बिल्कुल परेशान मत रहिएगा, क्योंकि मैं और मेरे जैसे कुछ टीचर एजुकेटर्स आपके साथ है. जो भी वीडियोज हम सब लोग अपलोड करें, हम उम्मीद करते हैं कि उसका प्रैक्टिस करने के बाद आपको एग्ज़ाम में बहुत ही अच्छे मार्क्स मिलेंगे. ये जो भी काम हम कर रहे हैं ये हम तहे दिल से कर रहे हैं, इतना याद रखिएगा. आज का वीडियो और इसके आगे के कुछ वीडियो ये स्टूडेंट टीचर्स के लिए ही रहेंगे, क्योंकि अभी यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जाम है तो उनके लिए ये वीडियो बनाना ये अभी की जरूरत है. तो अभी के जो भी वीडियोज रहेंगी वो स्टूडेंट टीचर्स के लिए रहेंगे, वो एमसीक्यू के ऊपर ही रहेंगे. मैं और एक वीडियो का टॉपिक आपको बताना चाहूँगी, जिसमें आपको ये पता चलेगा, जैसे कि पहले मैंने आपको बताया कि एमसीक्यू जब भी कोई भी टॉपिक आप पढ़ते हो तो पढ़ने के टाइम पे आपको आपके दिमाग में एमसीक्यू कैसे फ्रेम करने चाहिए. जो मैं खुद करती हूँ, जैसे कि कंटेंट मेरे सामने आते हैं तो ऑटोमेटिकली वो एमसीक्यू मेरे दिमाग में फ्रेम हो जाते हैं, उसके ऑप्शंस तैयार हो जाते हैं, क्वेश्चन तैयार हो जाता है, ठीक है. तो एक तो ये है, और दूसरी बात ये है कि आपको एमसीक्यू सॉल्व करना, मतलब इनिमिलेशन कैसे होना चाहिए, और बहुत अदर्स भी फैक्टर्स है. तो अगर उसके लिए उसके ऊपर भी आपको वीडियो चाहिए तो प्लीज़ आप अपने कमेंट्स कमेंट बॉक्स में लिखिए, ताकि वो टॉपिक टॉपिक के ऊपर भी मैं आपके लिए वीडियो बना सकूँ. And today's video, see, for example, whatever videos I uploaded before, mostly I use the English language, but I'm from today onwards, I'm going to use switch on both the languages, Hindi and English. And today's video is for my dear student teachers. This video is also related to school management subject. And today I'm going to deal with the unit number 2 and part 2. Yes, but before that, if you are new on the channel, then don't forget to subscribe the channel and press bell button too, so that you will get notification of upcoming videos. मैं और एक बात आपसे कहना चाहूंगी कि जो भी बहुत बार ऐसे होता है कि कुछ टॉपिक्स ऐसे है ना कि स्कूल मैनेजमेंट सब्जेक्ट से रिलेटेड बट अदर सब्जेक्ट से रिलेटेड भी, तो हमें समझ में नहीं आता ये पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक के एमसीक्यू कैसे पूछ सकते हैं। इसमें से है क्या कि जिसके ऊपर एमसीक्यू पूछ सकते हैं, क्योंकि हमारे दिमाग में पहले से ही बैठा हुआ रहता है, कुछ टाइप्स रहेंगे, कुछ पर्टिकुलर ईयर्स रहेंगे, कुछ ड्यूरेशन रहेगा, तो उसी के ऊपर ही एमसीक्यू पूछते हैं, कुछ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स रहेंगे। लेकिन ऐसे नहीं है, बहुत अदर चीजें भी है जिसके ऊपर एमसीक्यू पूछे जा सकते हैं। तो आज का हमारा वीडियो ऐसे ही टॉपिक से रिलेटेड है, जो भी स्कूल मैनेजमेंट का सेकेंड यूनिट से मैंने टॉपिक लिया हुआ है। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू प्रैक्टिस सम एमसीक्यूज रिलेटेड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक। ओके, एंड आई व्हाट एवर एमसीक्यूज आई हैव प्रिपेयर्ड, ऑल द एमसीक्यूज आर प्रिपेयर्ड बाय माय ओन। मैंने खुद सभी एमसीक्यूज बनाए हैं, और मैं उसका इमेज, जिस बुक से मैंने एमसीक्यूज बनाया है उसका इमेज और उसका पब्लिकेशन भी आपको जरूर बताऊंगी। तो चलिए चलिए प्रैक्टिस करते हैं MCQs ki. Today we are going to take practice of some MCQs on B.Ed. course 201, Quality and Management of School Education, Unit 2, Part 1. And as I told you that today we are going to take practice only on one topic, जिसको आपको समझ में नहीं आया था कि हाँ इसके ऊपर कैसे एमसीक्यूज पूछे जा सकते हैं। एंड द टॉपिक इज एसेंशियल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फैसिलिटीज इन सेकेंडरी एंड हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल्स। सो बेसिकली यू शुड नो, बेसिकली देयर आर 4 लेवल्स, द प्राइमरी लेवल, हायर प्राइमरी लेवल, सेकेंडरी लेवल एंड हायर सेकेंडरी लेवल। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू लेवल व्हिच स्टैंडर्ड्स आर इंक्लूडेड। सो फॉर प्राइमरी लेवल, as per the NP 1986 or you can say the reform NP 1992, the primary, that is first standard to fifth standard, the higher primary, that is 6th, 7th and 8th standard, and the secondary means 9th and 10th standard, and the higher secondary means 11th and 12th standard. So here we are going to practice some MCQs based on essential infrastructure facilities in secondary and higher secondary schools, means for the standard 9 to 12th. As I told you that whatever MCQs I have prepared, for all the MCQs I prepare from this book, that is School Administration and Management. This book is by SK Kocher, and the publication is Sterling Publishers Private Limited, New Delhi, India. This is very, very authentic book. And in the previous video also I told you that I think every teacher should have this book. Okay, so let's have some drilling. And the question is, Dash Dash has very rightly said, or can say very rightly stated, the density of India is being shaped in her classroom. The classroom is the basic unit of the school, and schools are units of our education system of the country. And the options are, total 4 options are there, A, B, C, D, A. NPE, that is National Policy on Education 1986. The second is Mudaliar Committee, or with the, you can also say that Mudaliar Commission. The C is Kothari Commission, and D is National Policy on Education 2020. If we see all these, the committee, commissions, policies, they are for the education. They are for the school education, for the higher education. Okay, now which is the correct answer? Because all agencies, or we can say the all policies, policies, committees. There are so many policies, committees, and commissions that are working for the education. But here, which is the correct option? So here, option number C, that is Kothari Commission, is the correct one. And this Kothari Commission, it is also called as National Education Commission, and the duration is 1964 to 1966. Because this Kothari Commission was formed on 14 July 1964, and this particular commission is dissolved on 29th June 1966. So there is a duration of Kothari Commission 1964 to 1966. Yes, the next question is dash dash says the school site should be near a road, yet back from the road as far as can be arranged to escape as much dust as possible. And the options are option number A, W.M. Ryburn, option number B, Dr. Olson, option number C, American Association of School Administration, and option number D, none of the above. Now we have to find out which option is correct. If we see, just first we have to think about the previous three options, that is W.M. Ryburn, Dr. Olson, American Association of School Administration. Yes, so here Dr. Olson, he has written one book, a book on the child development. And in that book, he told that what are the six main essential components for the child growth. So we are going to eliminate the first, that is option number B first. Then we'll think about the American Association of School Administration. Okay, so here American Association of School Administration has suggested a total 7 principles for planning a school plant building. Okay, and there is no particular says by this American Association of School Administration. So again, we are going to eliminate that option number C. Okay, and the correct option is, so here W.M. Ryburn says the school site should be near a road, yet back from the road as far as can be arranged to escape as much dust as possible. So this says is of W.M. Ryburn. If you have visited my previous video, so in that video there was one question related to, and the answer was the same, means answer was W.M. Ryburn, and the question was related to the position of bench and desk. And basically there are three positions: zero position, minus position, and plus position. So according for the writing and reading, so as according to the Ryburn, the which is the best position for writing and reading too. Okay, and the correct option was the zero position. So here you can please remember that. Actually, answer of this question I given in the previous, while explaining the previous question. American Association of School Administration has suggested dash dash principles for planning a school plan building, and the options are A, B, C, D. Option number A, that is 5, option number B, that is 7, option number C, that is 9, option number D, that is 6. So as I told you that total 7 principles are there. American Association of School Administration has suggested total 7 principles for planning a school plant building. So here we are going to lock option number B as a correct option. Yes. One more question is related to the same, that is American Association of School Administration. It has suggested 7 principles for planning a school plant building. And out of the following, which principle is not suggested by AASA, that is American Association of School Administration? So here you're supposed to know all the 7 principles given by the American Association of School Administration. So let's see what are the options. There are 4 options. Option A, that is economy. Option B, that is adaptability. Option C, that is safety and well-being. And option D, that is effectivity. So here I'm going to lock option number D as a correct option, because total 7 principles are given by the American Association of School Administration. And you can see that 3 principles are here. So let's see what are the 7 principles. The first principle, that is the curriculum adequacy. The second is safety and well-being. Third is interfunctional coordination. The fourth is efficiency and unity. Fifth is beauty. sixth is adaptability, and seventh is economy. So already we have locked the option number D, which is odd man out. The question is, the school building committee of the Central Advisory Board of Education Delhi has recommended dash dash area for the school building for 160 student. Okay, if we see, so whatever, there is a chart given by the Central Advisory Board of Education. Okay, the school building committee of this particular board, that is Central Advisory Board of Education. So whatever recommendations they have given, according to them, they have given the recommendations that if the student size is 160, number of students in the school is 160, is 320, is 480. So according to them, there should be particular area for the building and the particular area for the playground. So here, if we see, the question is, okay, so they are asking the area for the building. Okay, so let's see what are the options. The options are A, B, C, D, and or A, that is 1 acre, B, that is 1 1/3 acre, C, that is 2/3 acre, and D, none of the above. So if we see, as per the recommendations given by this particular board, the school building committee of this particular board, the correct option is 2/3 acre. Okay, and if you want that particular chart, okay, let me explain you that chart. If the student, I think one more question is there. First, we have practice of that question, and then I will explain you about the area required, area for the building and area for playground. One more question based on this, that is the school building committee of the Central Advisory Board of Education. So here, maybe they will ask questions that dash dash committee of the Central Advisory Board of Education Delhi has recommended particular area for the playground for 320 students. So such kind of questions can be asked in your final examination or the university examination. So here the correct answer is for this question, option number B, that is the correct one. Actually, I forgot to tell you the options. There were four options, that is 2.3 acre, the B, that is 4.5 acre, C, that is 6.7 acre, and D, none of the above. And if you see, the school building committee of the Central Advisory Board of Education, Delhi has recommended 4.5 acre area for playground for 320 student. Agar school mein 320 student hai, unke liye itna playground area hona zaruri hai. So this is the recommendation given by the school building committee of Central Advisory Board of Education. I just love this statement. Okay, so let's see what is the question is. Dash dash has very rightly stated, the collection of books, even a collection of good books, does not constitute a library. Given enthusiastic teachers who teach with books and librarian who can cooperate with them in converting the library into intellectual workshop, even a comparatively small collection of sensible chosen books may work wonder in the life of the student. And this is rightly stated by, the correct answer is again the Kothari Commission. So Kothari Commission, see the great thought of the Kothari Commission. Okay, so it tells us that the role of a teacher and role of a librarian too. Yes, so before moving ahead, if you are not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe it. If you like this video, please like it, share it with your friends, kyunki hamesha knowledge ko share karna chahiye. Abhi to bahut sensitive situation hai, bachon ke paas learning material nahi hai, to ye aapki bhi ek naitik zimmedari hai ki aap ye learning material ko aapke friends ke saath, aapke college mates ke saath aap share kijiye. Agar aapko ye video acha laga hai, to please aap ye video ke upar comment dena na bhuliye. Okay, the this question is, on the words of late Prime Minister dash dash, it seems to me more important to have a proper house for the teacher than to put up a building for the school. The teacher could keep the equipment and teach outside. The school revolves around the teacher and not around the building. ये एक्चुअली ये जब मैंने पढ़ा था मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा था, मतलब टीचर को कितना ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंस दिया है जवाहरलाल नेहरू. यस एंड द करेक्ट ऑप्शन ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज जवाहरलाल नेहरू. एंड सी कितना बहुत सुंदर थॉट है उनका कि वो ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंस देते हैं टीचर को ना ही बिल्डिंग को. टीचर ज्यादा से ज्यादा क्या कर सकता है, इक्विपमेंट्स अपने पास रख सकता है, बाहर जाके पढ़ा सकता है, लेकिन ये बात सही है कि जो स्कूल से वो रिवॉल्व होता है किसके किसके अराउंड, टीचर के अराउंड, बिल्डिंग के अराउंड वो रिवॉल्व नहीं होता. ये बहुत ही बढ़िया थॉट है जो दिया है जवाहरलाल नेहरू जी ने, जो हमारे लेट प्राइम मिनिस्टर रह चुके हैं. This question is regarding the different education commissions or the committees or the policies. Dash dash report says, we feel that the presence of the headmaster and the staff in or near a school, particularly if there are hostels attached or where the schools are residential, will be a greatest benefit to the school going population. Okay, so answer of this question is the Mudaliar Commission, which is also called as Secondary Education Commission. And this, in the what a report given by the Mudaliar Commission 1950 to 53, as per that report, there is says that they feel that the presence of the headmaster and the staff in or near a school, particularly if there are hostels attached or where the schools are residential. किसी भी स्कूल का अगर हॉस्टल अटैच है या फिर अगर स्कूल रेसिडेंशियल स्कूल है तो वहाँ पे नियर बाय जो भी हेड मास्टर या फिर जो स्टाफ मेंबर्स है वो रहते हैं, उनका रेसिडेंशियल अगर नियर बाय रहेगा तो वो सबसे ज़्यादा बेनिफिट्स होगा स्कूल गोइंग पॉपुलेशन को, यानी उसका सबसे ज़्यादा बेनिफिट होने वाला है स्टूडेंट्स को. This question is related to the one more infrastructure, that is museum. Yes, it is a material resource. The dash dash says museum plays a great part in the education of school children, as they bring home to them much more vividly than any prosaic lectures the discoveries of the past and the various developments that have taken place in many fields of science and technology. Museums as a agency of education and recreation is invaluable, and this is the great sage of, yes, this is the great sage of why I have selected that D option, because here what are options I given here, that is Mudaliar Commission, option A, that was the Mudaliar Commission, B, that is Secondary Education Commission, and C is the Kothari Commission. If we see the Mudaliar Commission, that is another name of Secondary Education Commission. So I have selected the option number D as a correct option. The question is, which type of design used for the secondary schools? And the options are I, U, H, and the last, that is D, all of the above. If we see whatever designs are given for the secondary schools in our country, so it includes all these three, that is I, U, and H. So here we are going to select the option number D, that is the correct one. This question is related to the school building and the design of the school building. Find out odd man out from the following group related to the type of design used for the secondary schools. So here you should know that which type of design used for the secondary school. So mostly we are using the shape, the I, L, T, U, E, and H. So here you can easily make it out that which is the odd man out. So whatever just now whatever designs I told you, so here we are going to select option B as a correct one, which is the odd man out. This question is related to one more infrastructure, that is the bench and desk. Three things must conform to the conditions required before the desk can be declared as the best. Find out odd man out from the following options. And the options are the height of the desk, the seat, place to keep books and notebooks and the writing surface. So if you see, there are three things and that must be conformed to the conditions required before the desk. वहाँ पे एक तो यह है, उसकी height proper होनी चाहिए, proper sitting arrangement होना चाहिए, तो seat उसका proper होना चाहिए and writing surface भी उसका proper होना चाहिए, ज़्यादा slanting भी नहीं होना चाहिए, ठीक है. सो इफ वी सी, वहाँ पे अगर बुक्स रखने के लिए या नोटबुक्स रखने के लिए जगह नहीं रहेगी तो भी चलेगा. सो बेसिकली द थ्री थिंग्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट ऑड मैन आउट एंड हियर द ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री, इट इज द ऑड मैन आउट. सो आई एम गोइंग टू लॉक ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री. Yes, and this question is, the school and educational institutions have a great importance for our. And of course, this is very simple questions because they are not only for the society, they are not only for the community, they are not only for the national development, because there is a linking between the education and national development. So here we are going to select option number D, that is the correct one. Yes. The next question is, the library is the hub of academic life of A, site, B, school, C, class, and D, none of the above. And the correct option is option number B, that is school. The library is the hub of academic life of school. So here already we have locked option number 2 as a correct option. So again, I request you, if you are new on the channel, please subscribe the channel. Press bell button. If you like this video, please like it, share it with your friends, and don't forget to comment on the comment box. Thank you.